Hi, welcome to our Pharma Topics channel, which aims at simplifying the pharmacy subjects and allied health sciences subjects, and also for the students who prepare for GPAT examinations. Today our topic of discussion is angina. Before entering into the anti-anginal drugs, let us see what is the pathophysiology of angina. In case of ischemic heart disease or the coronary artery disease, a transient coronary ischemia may occur, and that may reflect in the patient as angina pectoris, which is squeezing, gripping, like heavy discomfort. It is rather a discomfort, rather a pain. And there are different types of angina. One is classical angina or typical angina, which is purely related to atherosclerosis and excise induced. And the next is angina which occurs at rest, that is Prinz metal or variant angina, and angina which occurs at sleep. In case of typical angina, it is purely depend upon the workload of the heart. When the workload increases, angina increases. It is due to atherosclerosis. And one is stable angina, where the workload increases the anginal pain, and when they come at rest, the anginal pain gets relieved. In case of unstable angina, there are repeated episodes of the anginal pain. In case of sudden coronary artery spasm, angina pectoris may occur at rest, that is called Prinz metal angina or variant angina. And there is one special kind of angina which occurs at sleep, and that is called angina decubitus. Let us see the classification of anti-anginal drugs. There are two categories of drugs. Either they may increase the blood supply to the ischemic region, or they may decrease the myocardial oxygen supply. So it is divided into different categories. One is vasodilators, the most widely used organic nitrates. Organic nitrates are of different formulations, and they may be short acting, which is used in immediate cases, and some are intermediate acting, and some are long acting, which are used for prevention. And there are cardiodepressants, which reduce the workload, working of the heart. There are calcium channel blockers and beta blockers. And there are other category of drugs such as potassium channel openers, nicorandil, sodium channel openers, then partial fatty oxidation inhibitors, and a newer drug which is funny current inhibitor, that is ivabradin. So let us see the organic nitrates, how they work. The nitroglycerin is metabolized by an enzyme called aldehyde dehydrogenase, and that releases nitric oxide. The nitric oxide converts the GTP to cyclic GMP, and that causes venodilation with respect to the arterial dilation. It causes venodilation. The cyclic GMP activates protein kinase G, and that causes the influx of the release of calcium from the L-type calcium channels. They enter into the myocardial cell or the vascular epithelium, and that releases more calcium and leads to its vasodilation. The organic nitrates are nitroglycerin, isosorbide dinitrate, isosorbide mononitrate, pentaerythritol, tetranitrate, and amyl nitrate. All these drugs are venodilators. There are different formulations available: sublingual, oral, topical, transdermal, and intravenous. The repeated use of the transdermal patches may cause tolerance. And there is a newer drug called molcidomin, where the tolerance does not develop. The adverse effects are related to its vasodilation, particularly throbbing headache or heavy headache, hypotension, dizziness. Since they are vasodilators, reflex tachycardia is the prominent adverse effect. So The organic nitrates should not be given along with phosphodiesterase inhibitors such as sildenafil because of the dangerous hypotension, tachycardia, and it may lead to fatal angina. The organic nitrates are used for stable angina pectoris, acute coronary syndrome, Prinz metal or variant angina, and congestive heart failure. The other uses are, since it relieves the spasm, it may be used for biliary colic, esophageal spasm. Amyl nitrate is also used for treating cyanide toxicity. The next category of drugs are calcium channel blockers. They block the L-type voltage-gated calcium channels, so the influx of calcium entering into the cell is reduced. So the available calcium to stimulate the ryanodine receptors of the sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum gets reduced. The calcium channel blockers are amlodipine, felodipine, nifedipine, and all the dipines, and they act exclusively on the vascular bed. And some calcium channel blockers like phenylalkylamines, they act on the heart and they don't work on the blood vessels such as verapamil and diltiazem. The verapamil and diltiazem decrease the SA node automaticity, cardiac contractility, and AV node conduction. And there, all these calcium channel blockers are used for classical as well as variant angina. The other uses are, they are used as antihypertensives, cardiac arrhythmias. Nimodipine is specially indicated for treatment of subarachnoid hemorrhage. The adverse effects are, the nifedipine may cause hyperglycemia and urinary difficulties, that is voiding difficulty. Verapamil may cause constipation and ankle edema. And other adverse effects are headache, dizziness, fatigue, flushing, and peripheral edema. The drug interactions include the calcium channel blockers, when they are combined with the digoxin, they decrease the clearance of digoxin and enhance the toxicity of digoxin. The next category of drugs are beta blockers. When catecholamines work on the beta receptors, then they stimulate the formation of cyclic AMP and protein kinase A, which leads to opening of the L-type voltage-gated calcium channels, and the cascade of events happen, which leads to myocardial contraction. The beta blockers block the binding of catecholamines or the adrenergic catecholamines to the beta adrenergic receptors. The beta blockers are atenolol, metoprolol, nadolol, propranolol, and all the lols. All the beta blockers, they reduce the cardiac workload. They are used for classical angina and post-myocardial infarction. They can be combined with dihydropyridines, organic nitrates, to counteract the reflex tachycardia. They are used to reduce mortality in patients with coronary artery disease, particularly post-myocardial infarction patients. The beta blockers are contraindicated in case of variant angina, which is very important because they, due to the beta 2 blockade, they may cause vasoconstriction and worsen the Prinz metal angina. So it is not given for Prinz metal angina. The adverse effects are abrupt withdrawal may precipitate the angina. And the drug interactions are, beta blockers should not be combined with the calcium channel blockers which act exclusively at the heart, such as verapamil, because it may significantly reduce the cardiac output. Let us see nicorandil. Nicorandil is a new category of drug. It is a potassium channel opener. The potassium channel openers cause hyperpolarization of the L-type, the voltage-gated calcium channels, which leads to opening of it. Calcium influx occurs, which leads to myocardial contraction. So it is a myocardial ATP sensitive potassium channel opener and also a nitric oxide releaser. With reference to organic nitrates where tolerance develops, nicorandil has a special category drug where tolerance does not develop to its nitric oxide releasing property. The next drug is trimetazidine. It is a partial fatty oxidation inhibitor. When in case of angina, the myocardial muscle may use the glucose which is synthesized from the fatty oxidation instead of a regular pathway of synthesis of the ATP, that is through the Krebs cycle. So during this beta oxidation of fatty acids, more free radicals are generated. Trimetazidine is an inhibitor of partial fatty oxidation of the fatty acids, which is a very useful drug. It works by non-hemodynamic mechanisms when compared to other drugs. It decreases the number of anginal episodes and also increases the working of heart, the ejection fraction in patients with left ventricular ejection failure. The newer drug next category is ranolazine. It is a late sodium channel inhibitor. So the exchange for sodium and calcium is blocked by ranolazine. When the exchanger works, it puts excess intracellular sodium and calcium, which leads to disturbance in the oxygen supply and demand during ischemia. So this is a new category drug, which is a late sodium channel inhibitor, particularly by the ischemic area. So it blocks the pathological activation and prolongation of the late inward sodium current in the heart cells. It is the first line agent approved for chronic stable angina. They reduce the diastolic wall tension, improves the diastolic subendocardial perfusion, and reduce the oxygen consumption. Unlike other anti-anginals, it has no effect on the heart rate or the blood pressure. The next new drug is ivabradin. It is very new. It is a funny current blocker. It reduces the automaticity of the SA node. So the number of impulses generated from the heart is reduced in case of overworking or over impulse generating angina. So you just remember ivabradin with a clue. You just remember the drug nomenclature itself. It is a funny current blocker. It causes visual disturbances. There are visual acuity is affected as the adverse effects. And brady refers to bradycardiac agent. It decreases the cardiac rate without affecting conduction or contractility. So this is a nutshell of the anti-anginal drugs. I hope you enjoyed this categories of anti-anginal drugs. Thank you for listening. Happy learning. Kindly share this to your friends and kindly subscribe to our channel to encourage us to put more videos related to the pharmacy profession. Thank you.